In this quick video, we're going to set up content negotiation for a Spring REST API. We are basically going to start with a JSON-driven API, and we are going to start introducing XML and then consuming the API with that XML support. Let's start with adding the XML dependency here in Maven. And we are actually going to use the Jackson XML module, which is quite an interesting option we have starting with Spring 4.1. So previously we had other libraries such as the Xtreme library, but using any of those libraries traditionally meant that we needed to annotate our DTOs with extra annotations, and it also meant that we needed to learn and configure an extra library, which is not ideal. So using the Jackson first class support for XML is hugely powerful because we're going to still be using Jackson and we will benefit from all the well-known configuration that we already have a good grasp on with Jackson. So let's add this here. So very simple, exactly like the Jackson dependencies, we are adding here the Jackson data format XML dependency, and that brings out-of-the-box XML support to our API. We are actually going to add another dependency, which is going to replace the default out-of-the-box stacks implementation that we get in the JDK. And the main reason we're going to go with another stacks implementation is that it's much more well-maintained and generally a better, more mature implementation. So let's add the dependency here. The library is called Woodstocks, and it's quite well-maintained and super fast. And we're all set. This is the full XML support that we need in terms of libraries to enable XML support in the API. Okay, so now that we have added the XML libraries in Maven, they're now available at runtime, so they're also available to Spring. And so exactly like Jackson, Spring will detect the new library and it will enable XML support out of the box. We will of course configure that, tune it, and go into more detail, but it is important to understand that out of the box is a decent experience and we are going to see what that looks like right now. So let's now consume the privileges collection resource. Okay, so we are getting the 200 OK here as expected, and so let's now see what the body looks like, and notice that we are not providing any accept header. So we're not informing the API what kind of media type we want for our representations. We are just asking without any specific information there. Okay, so you can see that now we're getting XML instead of JSON. And why is that? Well, the out-of-the-box configuration is good, but we don't really have control over which of the HTTP message converters actually goes first. So in this case, the XML message converter went first, and so we are getting XML if we're not specifying anything. We can definitely have full control over the order of those HTTP message converters, and so we can determine which goes first and which is the default, but it's always, always, always good practice to use the accept header and to specifically ask for a media type for our representations. So even if we only support JSON, it's always good from the point of view of the client to ask for specifics, because who knows, in the future the API might support XML. And if you're not asking for specific as a client of an API, then you might get something else in the future. So let's see how that looks if we now set the accept header. So we're going to define it now. We're also going to save it as a favorite. And let's go. And here we are. We are getting the right representation now, we are getting JSON, and so that is basic content negotiation from the point of view of the client, asking for a specific media type by using the accept header and getting that representation correctly delivered back to the client. So there we have it. We are now supporting both JSON as well as XML in the API, and content negotiation is actually working and serving up the right kind of media type, depending of course on what the client asks for. If you'd like to go a lot more in depth on content negotiation and understand exactly how the HTTP media converters work with Spring and how Spring actually does content negotiation in terms of selecting the right HTTP message converter, definitely check out the second course out of REST with Spring. All right, hope you're excited. See you in the next one.